Hi, welcome back. Today's topic is how to build this. It took me 2 months to finish, but you don't need much time like that. Let me show you.
First, we need a body. So I went over to Sketchfab and searched for a tank model. I ended up finding this one, the M4A1 tank. Big thanks to the creator for sharing this file for free. After downloading, I needed to split it into 2 separate parts. That way, I could make space inside for the battery and circuit.
This is what I have after several days of working in Blender. This is not the first version. Actually, I have done a lot of printing before. So my first idea was to use the whole lower part of the body for the battery. So I use a stepper model for the tower. But because this stepper model runs with 18 degrees per step, the tower just didn't turn smoothly. So I have to move on to the second idea, using a DC model with a gearbox. This setup provides a 136:1 ratio, which is low enough for the tower. The only trade-off is because the model is a little bit tall, so I have to use a smaller battery.
Here is my final design. To bring it to life, I needed a resin printer. Huge thanks to Elegoo for sending me their Saturn 4 Ultra 16K. This is a high-resolution printer that's absolutely amazing. It even comes with an integrated camera. That means I can upload my file, start the print remotely over the internet, and monitor the entire process from anywhere. And the best part, in less than an hour, the tank body was complete.
We now have the body and the tower. To assemble it, we will need some electronic components. The ESP, a battery, one model for the tower, 2 separate for each track. We also need some model drivers. And here what I have after 1 hour, my custom PCB. You might be wondering how to wire it. Let me show you the wiring.
Here is the ESP. Motor and driver, battery. Join 5 and 6, 7 and 8 to the motor, power via 3 and 4, control 1 and 2 from any GPIO, then duplicate for another track and tower.
Now is the most challenging part, the track. My original idea was to have all the pieces of the track already connected right after printing. But because the design was so small, so here what I got. A solid circle, so I have to print a bunch of separate pieces and then connect them manually.
If you are questioning about where did I get this tiny copper wire, it's the internet cable. But remember the size, depending on the quality of the cable. The one I'm using here is about 0.35mm in diameter. It should fit perfect on my design.
Finally, it's done. Not too bad. To control it, I'm using this app.
To connect, we first scan for the ESP and select it. You'll see several available characteristics, but the last one is the one we programmed with the Arduino code. Just pick it, and now we can control the tank.
Okay, that's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.